करुणाकरसूरीन्द्र गुरुवर्य पदाम्बुजाम् नवनीत नटोत्तम साम गुरुपंक्ति श्रीयन्नुमहा। द ग्रेटनेस ऑफ नम्माळ्वार पार्ट टू। लॉर्ड श्रीमन नारायण सेंड्स डाउन हिज डिवाइन ऑर्नमेंट्स एंड डिवाइन वेपन्स एस इनकारनेशंस कॉल्ड द आळ्वार्स और दिव्य सूरीस एंड द मेन आळ्वार और द प्रधान आळ्वार एस दे से इस नम्माळ्वार। And this Nammalvar is also known to be an incarnation of the Lord's Commander-in-Chief Vishvaksena. And some sources claim that the Lord himself came down as an Amsha in the form of Nammalvar. So, in the previous part, we saw the episode of the incarnation of Nammalvar on this earth. Nammalvar was born as the son of Kari and Udayanangai in the divine place called Tirukkurugur. And this child, as it was born, did not cry or did not move. When the child was taken to the temple of Tirukkurugur, it crawled and went and sat beneath the tamarind tree, which was to the north of the temple. This tamarind tree was none other than Adisesha, who was awaiting the arrival of this divine child. The child was called as Maran because he was different from everybody else. And he was called as Shatakopan because he conquered the Vayu called Shata, which is responsible for Ajnana or lack of knowledge. This divine child was graced with knowledge, with teachings, with mantropadesha from Vishvaksena as directed by Lakshmi Devi and Lord Sriman Narayana. After this, Nammalvar or Maran Shatakopan sat under this tamarind tree for a whole period of 16 years. He sat in the same position of Padmasana, having a Jnana Mudra on the right hand, placing his left hand on the lap, having his eyes closed, being motionless, and having his head and neck held absolutely straight like a picture-perfect lamp. It was like a painted picture of this Alvar sitting under the tamarind tree. Absolutely still, not talking to anybody, and attaining the age of 16 years. At this time, in North India, in the city of Ayodhya, there was another Alvar called as Madhura Kavi Alvar, who had gone on a pilgrimage to Ayodhya. He suddenly saw a light which emanated from the southern direction. His curiosity was aroused and he started following that light. This was a light which was appearing to him even in broad daylight. In broad daylight, when the sun was shining bright, he could still see this light specifically and distinctly. So, Madhura Kavi Alvar started following the direction of that light. It led him southwards. He reached Chitrakuta and the light was still coming from the south. After a while, he reached Puri. It was still coming from the south. After some days, he reached Tirumala and the light was still coming from the south. After a few days, he reached the Divyadesam of Srirangam and still he found the light coming from the southern direction itself. So, Madhura Kavi Alvar travelled further south and found that the source of this light emanated from Tirukkurugur, and it emanated from a person who was seated under the tamarind tree of the Tirukkurugur temple. He went about inquiring in the village, in the town, about who this person was. And people told him the extraordinary story of Maran Shatakopan. Madhurakavi Aalvar was very impressed. So he went and tried to communicate with Shatakopan. When he tried to make some sounds, Shatakopan did not move. So he thought maybe he should just ask him a question. And that's exactly what he did. He asked him a question, which is a very famous one. He said, Settadu vayitril siriyadu pirandal, yettai tindru enge kidakkum. Now, we need to understand the meaning of this question. Settadu vayitril means, if something is born inside a dead thing, siriyadu pirandal, if a small being is born inside a dead thing, yettai tindru enge kidakkum, what will it eat and where will it lie? This is the exact translation of the sentence. But we need to understand a deeper meaning of this sentence to know what Madhurakavi Aalvar exactly asked Shatakopa. The meaning of this sentence is, this body or sharira is achetana. Achetana is something which does not have jnana or knowledge. It cannot perceive or understand another thing. So, such a thing is also called as jada. Jada means something which is lifeless. And lifeless is equivalent to dead. So, settadu here means dead or lifeless, or the one which does not have knowledge or jnana or achetana. So, inside an achetana, settadu vayitril. If a small light of life comes in, siriyadu pirandal. Now here, what is siriyadu? Siriyadu refers to a small atomic thing. Now, a small atomic entity full of life is called jivatma. Anutve sati chetanatvam desi. Meaning, the one which has knowledge, which is a bearer of knowledge, and which is extremely small in size. Smaller than being microscopic. If such a soul, a jiva, siriyadu, comes into the achetana or settadu, settadu vayitril siriyadu pirandal, then what happens if a soul, jiva, comes into a body which is achetana, then yettai tindru enge kidakkum, what will it eat and where will it lie? So this was the question. If a soul appears inside a body, what are its activities? So this is the question which was portrayed by Madhurakavi Aalvar to Nammaalvar in a very, very common language. It needs a lot of interpretation to even understand this. And this question was posed by Madhurakavi Aalvar to Nammaalvar in a very simple manner with a very few words. Now, Shatakopa or Nammaalvar answered back in fewer words than even the question. What was the answer? When he was put forth the question of Settadu vayitril siriyadu pirandal yettai tindru enge kidakkum, Shatakopa answered, Attai tindru ange kidakkum. The translation of this is, it will eat that and lie there. Where will it, what will it eat and where will it lie was the question. He said, it will eat and lie there itself. Now we have understood the internal meaning of the question. What is the internal meaning of the answer now? If a soul or a jiva happens to enter inside a body or a chetana, what will its activities be? Its activities will be, this is the answer, its activities will be, because of being associated with this sharira or achetana, this soul, this jiva will experience happiness or sorrow, that is sukha or dukkha, and continue to remain in that body or chetana as long as it is destined to be. Which means if a soul enters a body, it starts experiencing the happiness or sorrow through that body. The body of a person is a means for experiencing the fruits of the karma which has been associated with the soul. So, essentially, to give the fruits of actions of karmas, souls enter different bodies and experience joy or sorrow. So, this kind of a technical question was answered with great technical excellence by Shatakopa, and on hearing the answer, Madhura Kavi Alvar fell at the feet of Shatakopa. He said, O knowledgeable one, I consider you as my acharya, preceptor. Please accept me as your shishya. And Shatakopa gracefully accepted Madhura Kavi. After all, after a whole span of 16 years, he opened his eyes and mouth for the first time to answer the question of Madhura Kavi Alvar. So, he very graciously accepted him as his shishya. And after this, it is said that the Lord Sriman Narayana came along with Lakshmi Devi on Garuda and gave a beautiful vision or darshan to Alvar here. Alvar or Shatakopa here. Looking at the Lord, Shatakopa was completely overwhelmed. And after this Lord gave him such a darshan, it is said that the lords of the 108 Divya Deshas also came in a row to give darshan to this great Shatakopa. Now, what are Divya Deshas? In the last part, we heard that the divine ornaments of the Lord are called as Divya Abharanas. The divine weapons are called as Divya Ayudhas, and the incarnations of these Divya Abharanas and Divya Ayudhas are Divya Suris or the Alvars. The compositions of these Divya Suris are called as Divya Prabandham, and the holy shrines visited by the Divya Suris are called as Divya Deshams. So these Divya Deshams are very popular. They are 108 in number. And it is said that all the lords came and gave their darshan to Shatakopa placed under this tamarind tree. It is said that the Lord of Srirangam, also called as Namperumal, very fondly called this Shatakopa as Nam Alvar. Alvar, as we said earlier, is the one who is immersed deeply in devotion. And Nam Alvar means my Alvar. One who is very dear to me. So, this Alvar was very, very dear to the Lord and so was called as Nam Alvar. He is also very dear to us because, as said earlier, he is Prapanna Jana Santana Kutastha, meaning he is the leader for all those who desire to take up surrender or who have surrendered at the feet of the Lord. So, being a very popular one, he is termed as Nam Alvar. It is said that the Lord of Tirukurugur, Adipiran, always used to send his Vakula Mala to Nammalvar. So, he is also known as Vakula Bharana. He would always be wearing the Vakula Mala or the garland of Vakula flowers given by Adipiran, and so is called as Vakula Bharana. Nammalvar saw all these lords and then decided to start composing divine hymns on the Lord. Nam Alvar has composed four works, which are known to be the essence of the four Vedas. The first work composed by Nam Alvar is known as Tiruvirutham. It comprises of 100 pasurams or 100 verses, and the Tiruvirutham is the essence of the Rig Veda. Next, he composed the Tiruvasiriyam, which has 7 verses and is known to be the essence of Yajurveda. Nammalvar's third work is the Periya Thiruvandadi, which comprises of 87 pasurams and is known to be the essence of Atharvana Veda. Finally, Nammalvar composed his grand work called the Thiruvai Mozhi, which comprises of 1102 shlokas or verses or pasurams and is known as Samaveda Saram, the essence of the Samaveda. Through his compositions, he established the supremacy of Lord Narayana and tied the rope of successful establishment of Visishtadvaita Siddhanta. Because he tied this rope of victory, which was also used to vanquish people of opposing schools of thought, he is known as Parankusha. Ankusha means rope. And this rope was used as a weapon to ward off the vices of the other schools of thought, which do not lead to the right path of attaining eternal happiness. By using these methods of establishment of supremacy of Lord Narayana, Nammalvar also tied Lord Narayana with his greatness and devotion, and hence is also called as Parankusha. Para means Lord Narayana, who is supreme, and Ankusha means rope. So Parankusha would mean either the one who tied the rope of success to the Visishtadvaita Siddhanta, which was also used as a weapon to ward off other schools of thought and thus established the Paratva of Lord Narayana, or the rope of devotion which actually tied Lord Narayana himself, who is Para. Thus, this great Parankusha has wonderful compositions which can be spoken about, read, heard and interpreted in many, many ways. The Thiruvai Mozhi is considered to be one of the Grantha Chatushtayas. There are four Granthas which a Sri Vaishnava must essentially know about. And the four Granthas are the Sri Bhashya, the Gita Bhashya, the Rahasya Trayasara and Bhagavad Vishayam. Bhagavad Vishayam is nothing but the commentary to Thiruvai Mozhi. Bhagavad Vishayam essentially means something about Bhagavan. A Vishayam about Bhagavan, meaning information about the Lord. Now, all Itihasas, Puranas, Vedas, everything give us information about the Lord. But they are not called as Bhagavad Vishayam. They are not specifically called as Bhagavad Vishayam. Whereas, the commentary to the Thiruvai Mozhi is known as Bhagavad Vishayam. Why? The answer is, Vedas or Puranas or Itihasas actually speak about Lord Sriman Narayana sometimes. And they also have other aspects inside them which need an interpretation to be understood the right way. Whereas, Nammalvar's verses are laden only with Lord Narayana and his devotion and his experience. So, this is the actual Amrita or essence of the Lord. So, it is called as Bhagavad Vishayam. This Bhagavad Vishayam can be heard and heard for time eternal. It is so rich in experience and devotion.